Today, you're watching PTS English News. I'm Ethan Liu. The Central Epidemic Command Center said the latest wave of the outbreaks has become manageable, as evidenced by the virus RT value, which predicts the number of people a patient could infect, has dropped from 15 to 1.02. Experts say, however, people should remain vigilant, as it could be an underestimation.
Over 8,000 confirmed cases and over 100 deaths have been reported since the onset of the latest COVID-19 outbreak in Taiwan. According to the Central Epidemic Command Center, the RT value has dropped from 15 to 1.02, in which the CECC considers to be a sign the epidemic is becoming manageable. Doctors say, however, that this figure should be taken with a grain of salt, since not everyone who has contracted the coronavirus could necessarily be found.
我们在计算 RT 值的时候，就是你的所有的确诊病例都能够找到的话，它的数值自然就会比较准确。不过在实际的情形之下，在一个疫病大规模流行的情况之下，你是不可能去找到所有社区隐藏的病例啊，所以它就是会有一点。 那个低估 RT 值的现象。
Doctors explain that the RT value measures the average number of persons one individual with the virus can infect, and the value was usually high in the beginning because there were many cluster infections. When the RT value reduces to less than 1, the epidemic will gradually disappear. More observation is needed since the current RT value may be underestimated.
RT 值的部分其实它会受限于不同区域的一个人口密度，以及当时的一个阳性确诊率的一个密度。那甚至说一些黑数的部分，其实都要列入考虑的话，台湾目前校正回归的一个病患量还是太多，所以要靠目前每天都在调整的一个校正回归，要进一步去找到所谓的一个 RT 值的一个正确估算其实不容易的。
Doctors stress that the RT value does serve as one of the guidelines to monitor the progress of the epidemic, but we do not have an objective value right now to determine when level 3 alert can be lifted. In order to consider lifting level 3 restrictions, there needs to be less than 10 confirmed cases overall with unknown source of infection and less than 3 cluster infections per week.
Buddhist Light International Association said it would like to donate 200,000 to 500,000 vaccines. The Central Epidemic Command Center said a one-stop window for applications will be established to offer assistance.
The Central Epidemic Command Center and Executive Yuan have finally given in to public demand and announced they will establish a one-step service specifically to support civic organizations in procuring COVID-19 vaccines. Buddha's Light International Association confirmed that it has already engaged the CECC in talks to discuss arrangements for the procurement of vaccines. It added it will enter into talks with pharmaceutical Johnson & Johnson on June 2nd.
台湾的时间要礼拜三了，啊，才会有初步的结果。跟他们沟通很久了，那应该是没有问题。那数量也确定在20到50万剂。
BLIA said it is still discussing this issue with the CECC, and it's still unknown who will sign the contract to purchase the vaccines. It added that it's not necessary for BLIA to sign the contract, and it will depend on the company. Members of the organization found out the government had problems procuring vaccines, so they decided to step in. Former Food and Drug Administration Director General Kang Zhaozhou has experience with companies purchasing vaccines to give to the government. Although this is a public health issue and the vaccines will require emergency authorization, the times are extraordinary, and Kang says the government should do everything it can to support civic groups that are capable of procuring vaccines. The government should take on the responsibility of inspecting the vaccines.
买去购也是透过民间去游说嘛，其实民间去买也是跟原厂买啊，不会是跟别人买吧。政府最重要的其实它就是把关就好了，就是说你进来的东西我要一定要看到原厂证明。
Foxconn Group founder Terry Guo has also applied to supply 5 million Pfizer-BioNTech vaccines. He has requested the Yongling Healthcare Foundation to complete 8 provisions related to procurement within 72 hours. The CECC said Economic Affairs Minister Wang Meihua has already spoken with Guo and told him to have the foundation complete the plan rapidly and submit it.
The public has expressed concerns over the safety of domestic vaccines as they haven't passed the phase 2 clinical trial. CECC Commander Chen Shizhong responded that many countries granted emergency use authorization even though vaccines have not passed phase 3 trials.
Local companies Medigen Vaccine Biologics Corporation and United Biomedical Incorporated Asia are both developing COVID-19 vaccines, and neither has passed the Phase 2 clinical trial yet. Double-blind trials have not been completed either. Nevertheless, the Central Epidemic Command Center has already signed contracts to procure domestic vaccines, leading to public backlash. CECC Commander Chen Shizhong defended the decision, saying the completeness of scientific evidence was the primary reference.
那其实大部分在一期出来之后，我们就积极的跟各个单位就做研究，收集相关的科学的证据。那开始在那时候就开始，然后签订契约。
Chen also said the Pfizer-BioNTech, Moderna, Johnson & Johnson, and AstraZeneca vaccines have not completed Phase 3 trials yet. Many countries granted emergency use authorization. He said that waiting until after the Phase 3 trial is complete would be too slow to meet the urgent need. The public has doubts about domestic vaccines due to the low number of people enrolled in Phase 1 and 2 trials. Chen asserted that the manufacturers had actually expanded the number of subjects in their Phase 2 trials, and their trials included more participants than those of the AZ, Moderna, and Pfizer-BioNTech vaccines. In Medigen Vaccine Biologics Corporation's Phase 2 trial, 3,852 people received the first dose and 3,815 received the second dose. In United Biomedical Incorporated Asia's Phase 2 trial, 3,875 people received the first dose and 3,844 received the second dose.
我们这是一个扩大型的第二期，基本上也可以视为是一个二三期的延续的一个计划。
There are also concerns that domestic vaccine manufacturers will not be able to keep up with the rapidly changing epidemic situation. Chen said domestic vaccines were developed early on, and the companies develop recombinant vaccines. He added that their pace is not slow compared to international manufacturers, and that vaccines are a strategic good, and Taiwan needs the ability to manufacture them itself. He also said the government needs to participate and invest. The reason why the contracts were signed so far in advance was to relieve the pressure on the companies and promote research.
A COVID-19 patient receiving treatment at Shuanghe Hospital in New Taipei City attacked three nurses with a knife, causing the victims to suffer stab wounds and other injuries. New Taipei City Department of Health condemns the violence and is asking local prosecutors for heavier punishment.
Three nurses serving at Shuanghe Hospital got stabbed and were injured by a patient surnamed Hong, who tested positive for COVID-19 on Monday, May 31st. Besides suffering from marks on hands and abdomen, two nurses also suffer from pneumothorax, as described by a netizen who claims to be a senior in school to the nurses. The other nurse is severely injured with her ligament and nerves cut. The hospital said the nurse is deeply traumatized and is now under attentive care.
再次重申，我们严厉谴责，也目前已经依法办理。那请大家继续为我们全国的医护人员加油。
Many medical personnel cried out online to the government for justice and for heavy punishment to this brutality, since they need help and assistance from the nation as a whole to fight against the coronavirus. In support, the New Taipei City Department of Health asked the court to issue heavier punishment for anyone exerting violence on medical personnel. The city also promises to take care of all frontline medical personnel during this time.
所有医护人员都穿着像太空人这样进去，看不到彼此之间的眼神。对有些病人确实是会觉得很担心、害怕。各个医院在对这样的病人，或者还有照顾这些病人的医务同仁呢，应该要有心理支持、关怀这样的机制。
The Taiwan Union of Nurses Association suggests to not provide quarantine patients with fruits that need to be sliced and cut, so knives will not be needed in the quarantine facilities. Hong, the perpetrator, is now under isolation and has not yet gone through interrogation online due to his emotional instability. Extra police force is on guard at the moment until his isolation period is over.
Now, bring us some top stories from around Taiwan. The central government said it will supply hospitals in Taipei and New Taipei City with N95 masks, protective gear, and other disease prevention products, up to two times the safety stock. All beauty and hair salons in Taoyuan have been ordered to close during the period starting June 4th to June 14th. Violators can be fined up to NT$15,000. New Taipei City Mayor Hou Youyi promised to make sure that all police within the city get vaccinated as soon as vaccines become available. So far, all 18,000 doses have been administered. The advanced subject test for university entrance is scheduled to take place from July 3rd to 5th. The Ministry of Education says it has already set up a contingency group to decide whether to postpone the test if the Level 3 alert is still in effect at that time. Meanwhile, schools say students who are scheduled to take this test will face more pressure if it is postponed.
School and cram school classes have been suspended under the Level 3 alert. High school seniors intending to sit for the advanced subjects test can only study at home. Many teachers have set up video links with students to allow them to ask questions, as well as vent.
老师会跟学生保持联系，帮他解答问题，就是说在后面这一段偏向于帮学生解答难题为主。
Schools are providing resources and channels to help students maintain a steady studying tempo and frame of mind. This year is the last year the test will be based on the old curriculum, so many students are hoping they can pass the test and not have to retake them. Sun Mingfeng, principal of Taipei Municipal Chenggong High School, says the school has 833 seniors and 55% are taking the AST. They are under more pressure compared to students from past years and will suffer greatly if the AST is postponed due to the epidemic situation.
这么长的时间，没有办法照过去原来所安排的节奏念书，而需要适应一个新的那个读书的节奏。那我相信那个孩子们应该会经过一段的调试期啊。我们感觉上是还有一点希望，是能够看是不是能够如期举行啊。
真的看到小孩子的压力真的是非常非常的大，其实我们家长的压力也不小。所以我们是还蛮希望就是能够如期举行。
The advanced subjects test is scheduled to take place from July 3rd to 5th. The Ministry of Education has given no indication as to whether it will be postponed. It only said it has already discussed disease prevention measures and contingencies with the College Entrance Examination Center and the Joint Board of College Recruitment Commission, and arrangements will be adjusted depending on how the epidemic situation changes. Some senior high school principals are hoping that the alert level will be lowered to level 2 within the next weeks so that the test can be held as scheduled.In the meantime, they are reminding students that staying in good health is what is most important.
Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.